caught, changed course, had the bank doors. Now them same doors got a man in wait force. Handshake still, cause the manners ain't lost. I'm floss when I cause I plan to stay raw. Had to take deals that ain't have a race seal, just to have a play field. Now I'd rather take all. Remember when it feels like you gotta stay still if the line ain't crossed. Before you break.
into the ballpark. Happy to have you with us. We've got a perfect night for baseball on the show. It's the St. Louis Cardinals going up against the New York Mets. All right, we'll be back to get this one started after this. And now, Tommy Edman.
Leading off by for St. Louis, the shortstop, Tommy Edman.
And a pitch. Swing and a miss. And a home opener. Is underway. Here's the 0-1. And ball one. Ball to strike. The pitch. Left field. Snags it on the run. And there's one down. Now it's chance in the head.
Kind of a throwback. No batting gloves.
Number nine, Danny Jensen.
That's in for a strike. And that one hammered. Kepler ranging back. Still going back. Makes the catch up against the wall. And here's Paul Goldschmidt.
Circus, I'm take this thing for. Talk to them in the army.
Let's get down to business. Yep. I don't got no time to play around. What is this? Never. Must be a circus in town. Let's shut the down on these clowns.
Ready.
Tell them say we are on the game, we not do this for the fame. Clowns be tripping, but we not listen what them saying. This lion can't tame, better get this in your brain. The spirit of the legends is flowing into my veins. I mean, you're still keeping them entertained while you're chopping the knowledge that made the picture in the frame. Keeping it militant is the mission and the aim, till you're seated with the gods and they remember the name.
Sometimes I feel like a 50 when he spit how to rob, cause I'm dirty spotlight, word is born. Sometimes I feel like I'm Eminem when he turned me shady and started calling out everyone as fugazi. Sometimes I feel like I'm Jay, sometimes I feel like I'm Diddy, sometimes I feel like I'm Drake, just trying to get to that Billy. Sometimes I feel like I'm game on a mission and just drop 300 bars of diss and I listen. Sometimes I feel like I'm pop, not the key.
Welcome from the home of the New York Mets, Citi Field in Queens. MLB The Show with a good one coming at you. It's the St. Louis Cardinals going up against the New York Mets. First pitch coming at you right after the break. All right, ready to go here. Digging in, Tommy Edman. And a pitch. And that's in the dirt. And we're underway here in the home opener. Next offering is in for a strike. To third, Riley. Throw pulls him off the bag and he's safe. Danny Jansen to hit here.
Danny Jansen.
That one fouled off. That misses the zone, and now it's even one and one. The 1-1 is fouled off.
Pretty good pitch there to take a rip at. He wants to get his arms extended. He likes the ball away from him a little bit, just not able to square it up.
And a 1-2. That's inside. The pitch knocks that one away and we'll do it again. The 2-2 now. Got him. And one out now. Now it's Goldschmidt up to the plate. The first baseman, Goldschmidt. Line drive, caught.
Well, baseball can be cruel, can it? I mean, sometimes it gives and sometimes it takes away. He did everything right on that swing, but he's got nothing to show for it.
Aloy Jimenez in the box here lets that one go for a ball. Swing and a miss. Strike one. And that's down and away.
Two balls, one strike.
This one in the air, center field. Azokar under it. Drops into the glove. And that is the third out of the inning. We go to the bottom of the first. And stepping in for New York, Jose Azokar. And the pitch. Swing and a line drive, base hit out of the center field. Off to a good start with a leadoff knock.
Well, clearly he was ready to hit right there. Just a cookie down the middle. I mean, those are the ones you dream about. Ones in the cage, you're just hoping you get in the ball game. Right down the middle, not a whole lot of velocity, right on top of it.
Yandy Diaz now. There's the strike. Azokar gets his lead at first with nobody out. Line drive, base hit. Lead runner holds up. They're at first and second with nobody out.
Two consecutive base hits for these guys here. That's about as textbook as it gets. Got his stride load out of the way early. He stayed inside that ball and squared it up out front. Man, that was like he was in the cage hitting off a tee.
Crushed in the air. Left center field. Way back there. No doubt about it. A towering shot, and that's how they take the lead. It's 3-0. Now the youngster Juan Soto.
Can be tough to bounce back after a big home run, but nobody on, nobody out. You just have to treat it as a fresh inning.
And the first pitch misses for ball one. Singy, maybe some nerves getting the best of him in the first?
Well, it's hard to know exactly if it's nerves or not, but he just doesn't have it right now. Those hitters on the other side, they're going to say it's nerves and use that as a competitive edge to try to jump on him even more.
And now 2-1.
Two balls, one strike.
Swings and sends a rocket to right. Castellanos makes the play, and there's one away.
Man, he smoked that fastball. He's all over it. It's just frustrating when you can't get it to fall. Maybe next time off, he'll find a hole.
Austin Riley stands in now and watches strike one. That one misses, and the count is 1-1. One down, base is empty. Swing and a miss. Slider right there. And that's a little bit high. Still only one out here in the inning. And now it's filled up. That one is absolutely belted. That's back there. Booyah! A solo shot. And they add to the lead. It's 4-0. Base is empty, one away. And here's the veteran outfielder, Max Kepler. First offering misses the mark.
Well, at this pace, he's not going to be in this game for very long. But he's got to find a way to shake it off, keep it isolated to one inning, come back out. You could throw up a bunch of zeros and save that bullpen.
All over that one right there.
Other than ripping one into the gap or blasting one over the wall, there aren't a whole lot of hits that are more satisfying than a nice line drive in the center field. So that definitely felt good.
Ronnie Mauricio now.
That's a ball.
That misses the zone. Ball one.
Well, they've been able to score four runs off of him in this inning, and this is where you want to just max out. Get as much as you can. Give him one of those tough innings where it's going to be hard for him to recover in the next one.
Now 3-0.
Well, I would expect in this 3-0 count, you're taking all the way. See if they walk you.
Out of line, out towards center. Makes the grab, out number two. Throw is high and over his head. Man at first. Here's the veteran shortstop, Enrique Hernandez. In the air, right field. And he can't quite get there. It's a foul ball. The pitch. And that one is inside, ball one. First inning, and already up to 23 pitches. Kicks and deals. Puts it in the air out towards left center. Brings it in for the third out. Welcome back. Top of the second. Nick Castellanos at the plate now.
Nick Castellanos.
Here comes a pitch. That to right. Tatis drifts towards it. And out number one on the grab. TJ Friedl next up for the Cardinals.
Batting fifth, the center fielder, TJ Friedl.
That's ripped. Base hit. So they get a man aboard with a one-out single.
Batting seven, the third baseman.
So a man aboard. Next to hit, Seiya Suzuki. And he swings and misses, and it's nothing at all. Friedl at first, one gone. And nope, it's even up. In the air to left center, Kepler drifts towards it and puts the squeeze on it. That's out number two. Michael Conforto will climb in.
The left fielder, number eight, Michael Conforto.
Check swing of the first pitch. Look down to third. Did not go. Next one misses, and it's 2-0.
2-0.
That one ripped. And it one hops the wall. Friedl around third. But now he hits the brakes and hustles back to third. Gleyber Torres up to the plate. This one chopped on the ground, but foul. The 0-1. And a foul ball. The pitch. Foul ball still, 0-2. Two outs, two in scoring position. That one missed.
Two strikes.
Thank you. Here's a 1-2. Gets a piece there. We'll do it again. Two on, two outs. Foul ball left side. He'll see another.
Five foul balls in this at bat so far, and these guys are going head to head. You can see the crowd. They're starting to get into it a little bit more, even though there hasn't been a ball in play yet.
Got him looking. That's a strikeout. Back here at the ballpark, here's the catcher, Francisco Alvarez. The pitch. There's a swing and a drive. That one's back. That's down. One hops off the wall. And he's got a double.
Went up there looking to be aggressive and got something he could handle. I love the approach he had right there with that pitch. Not trying to do too much, but still looking to drive it. And that's exactly what he's able to do into the opposite field gap for the double.
Azokar batting for the second time, and that's strike one. That one off the mark, and it's a ball and a strike. Runner at second, nobody out. Out towards left center. And that'll fall for a base hit. Here comes Alvarez around third.
A couple of hits in a row for him here. That ball right there landed in what they call the no man's land, meaning it's not really a spot on the field where you can expect anyone to get to it easily. I mean, it's a tough play going back for the shortstop, but also for the outfielders trying to come in. They got to go a long way as well.
At the belt and fires.
Clearly, he hasn't had it in this game, and looks like sooner than later, they're going to have to go to the bullpen.
And now one and two.
Two strikes.
On the ground, a short could be two. Over to Torres. On to Goldschmidt. That's two.
Well, almost any time you roll over and send a two ball to short at this level, you can pretty much count on a double play. Middle infielders are just so reliable, and they work on these plays all the time, so it almost becomes like second nature.
Hard hit left side. Slings it across, and they take care of Tatis for the out. Out number three. Here at Citi Field. And here comes Tommy Edman. And a pitch. And first offering is fouled off. And there's a ball.
I got one ball, one strike.
Swings and misses, and that is strike two. That's to third. Sends it to first. And one away in the top of the third. Now it's Jansen to hit. Went down on strikes his first time through. And that's in there for strike one.
If I'm at the dish right now, I am aggressive over the heart of the plate. This guy's been filling up the strike zone, so you know you're going to get a good pitch to hit. And as nasty as his stuff is, you might as well take all three swings.
Snags it for the second out. Here's Paul Goldschmidt, 0-1 so far.
The first base is
Goldie getting to start at first. 35 years old. He's one of the few Major League Baseball players born in the state of Delaware. Shoots a line drive single into right center. Now he'll turn for second. The throw in. Safely into second. He's got a double.
Now designated.
So two down, Aloy Jimenez. Next up for the Cardinals. 0 for 1 with a flyout. And a foul ball.
The strategy of winning a ball game, when you could make that pitcher work a little more, expose himself by throwing pitches, that could be the key to winning perhaps later on. So good job of extending this inning, getting a knock with two outs to bring the number four ball hitter up.
And that's down, a base hit. Now a long throw home. And he's in there. And a run comes in to score.
Puts a run on the board and picks up an RBI. You'll often hear the phrase short to it, long through it. And that's a great example of it right there. Got the barrel in the hitting zone early, squared it up with the well-timed swing, and came away with a beautiful line drive into center field.
Here's Nicholas Castellanos. There's a strike. And downstairs. And a pitch. And 1-2.
One ball.
Now he steps out as time is granted. The 1-2. And a swing and a miss. Good job at damage control right there. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. Now it's the DH, Juan Soto. Soto measures 6 feet, 2 inches. Batting in the cleanup spot, and he was born in the Dominican Republic. He swings and misses at the first pitch, 0-1. On a line, base hit.
Couldn't have timed it up any better than that. I could watch base hits like that one all day long, and so could every hitting coach in the league. Just a nice line drive into center field.
Here's Austin Riley. First pitch just misses. That clips a corner. Righty to the plate. And a count 1-2. Soto aboard here at first with nobody out. Base hit. Lead runner to second, so two on and nobody out.
Now batting, left fielder,
now batting Max Kepler. Swings and lines a base hit into left field. They won't test it here. Bases loaded, no outs. Now it's the second baseman, Ronnie Mauricio. He's 0-1. In the air on the infield, and the infield fly is called. Here's Kike Hernandez. Hit it well, but flied out to the deepest part of the outfield his first time. Ball one, no strikes.
Well, the good thing so far is that he hasn't issued any free passes. Unfortunately, they're making pretty good contact, so not getting the swings and misses and making that defense work behind him.
One out, base is full. Center field. Friedel makes the catch. Both runners tagging. The tag, and that's out number three, inning over. here in Queens. Start of the fourth. And now the center fielder, TJ Friedl. And he deals. And misses inside.
You know, these Cardinals showing great discipline at the plate, and patience definitely seems to be the name of their game in this one. He's only given up one run, but the starter's pitch count is starting to get up there, and that might be the best news yet for this offense.
Ball to strike. Bounced up the middle. There's Hernandez handling the chance. And a quick out number one.
Well, he's doing a nice job of keeping the ball out of the air. Lets the defense work behind him with another ground ball. Good execution. You know, sometimes all it takes is getting to the next arm before an offense does any damage. And that might be the case today.
Ripped to third and caught. Two outs, bases empty. Michael Conforto, the next to hit. Going one.
All one's the count.
Hard grounder into the outfield for a knock.
Now batter, second base.
Gleyber Torres Gleyber. Up to hit. And the first pitch misses for ball one. And now the lefty. Worm burner into the outfield for a knock.
Now batting.
Tommy Edman at the plate.
Tommy Edman.
Now he steps off and looks it back to second. In the dirt. Nice job behind the plate there. And the 1-0.
Inside, ball
good spot for the hitter. Definitely has the advantage in this count with runners on. Look for him to be aggressive on this next pitch.
Next one misses, and that's ball three. Swing and a high fly ball to left. Kepler under it. And that will end the inning. And welcome back. Bottom of the inning. And now the catcher comes up to him. Francisco Alvarez. Michaelis back to work. That's inside. And it's 1-0.
Well, these Mets doing a good job of simply getting the bat on the ball in this game. And the numbers back that up. And here's a stat for you, Boo. They're making contact with more than 85% of the pitches that they're swinging at. It's pretty special stuff. Not so good if you're out there on the mound.
Line drive, base hit. Makes the turn and heads for second. In safely, It's a double and his second hit.
Everything came together for him. Showed a willingness to drive that pitch the opposite way. Didn't get jumpy, didn't try to pull the ball. He let it get deep, took the barrel right to it, and then extended through the swing for the line drive base hit.
And the batter now, Jose Azucar.
Nope. Ball one.
First offering, and it just misses.
Ball one, no strike.
Swing and a ball popped up. Calls it in, and there's one away. So digging in, Yandy Diaz. Single to score back in the first. He's one for two. Line drive. Calls it in for the out. And the batter will be Fernando Tatis Jr. He's already homered in this game. Hit hard on the ground to short. Edmund slings to first. And that's the third out. Welcome back. Now the number two hitter, Danny Jansen.
Number nine, Danny Jansen.
The pitch. Popped up. Diaz moves under it. And he makes the catch. And there's one down.
He's been going after these guys consistently, and as a result, he's been able to keep his pitch count low, throwing the ball very well right now.
Swing and a line drive and a base hit up the middle.
Waste no time there. Everything was on time and fluid in that swing. Got a pitch he could get the barrel on and lined it into center for the knock. Those always feel good.
Eloy Jimenez now. That's inside. 1-0. That's a bullet, but it goes foul. Not even close there. Two balls and a strike. Kicks and fires. Still 2-2 after the foul ball. Goldie, the base runner at first with one out. And a pitch. Hard ground ball, base knock. They fired in quickly, so it's first and second with only one away. Nick Castellanos next up for the Cardinals. That one hit to right. Tatis drifts towards it, pulls it down, and he makes the catch. Two down. And here is TJ Friedl, one for two.
TJ Friedl.
Swings through that one. 0-1. First and second. Two down. Next offering is in for a strike.
Man, this guy's got a great feel for his breaking ball today.
swings and misses. It's a strikeout. Back here at the ballpark, we head to the bottom of the fifth. So now here's the Mets DH, Juan Soto. The wind of the pitch. That's in there. That's strike one.
Well, these Mets doing a good job of putting the ball into play, and that makes things more challenging on the defensive side. Double digit.
Oh, now this is blasted way back there on its way. Gone. He rockets one to right, and they tack on to their lead. It's 6-1. Here's the third baseman, Austin Riley. He's already homered here in this one. And first offering is fouled off. The wind of the pitch. Chris, you look at it. These are the spots where guys can come on, pitch well, instill some confidence in the manager, and all of a sudden they're pitching higher leverage spots of the postseason.
Well, in this final month, I mean, this is an audition period for the call-ups, but it's also for that marginal reliever that was on the roster throughout the season to maybe step up and be on that playoff roster.
Ripped to short. Over to Goldie. And that's the first out in the bottom of the fifth.
Fastball right down the middle. Usually a lot of damage done with that pitch. A hard grounder, but he wanted to get that ball in the air, maybe drive it into the gap.
Kepler, batting with one down, takes a strike. And that's in for a strike.
0-2 the count.
Good eye right there. And that one lifted in the air center field. Friedel makes the catch, and there's two down. Ronnie Mauricio up now for the Mets.
Second baseman, Ronnie Mauricio.
And he swings and misses at the initial offering. Good eye in that spot.
Just missed with a good breaking ball in, looking for that hitter to chase and perhaps get some weak contact or a swing and miss. Good job on both sides.
In the air, left side. Makes the grab, and that's the inning. Here at Citi Field, now the third baseman, Seiya Suzuki. The pitch. That smash towards center. Makes the grab on the run. And there's one away. And here is Michael Conforto. Conforto in his seventh season, 29 years old, and he's usually in right, today starting in left. First pitch, and he just misses.
Boog, if I was to break it down and make it simple, I would say right field's kind of a chill spot compared to left field. Left field's that second hot corner, in my opinion.
The 1-1. There's a swing and a miss.
One ball, two strikes.
And a pitch. And another ball.
Two strikes.
popped up. Hernandez hauls it in, two away. Here's Gleyber Torres.
Second base, Gleyber Torres.
And first offering is fouled off. Two down, nobody on. Ground ball, Austin Riley. Gets it to first. And Gleyber Torres retired. That's the third out. Here in Queens, bottom of the sixth inning, and stepping in for New York, Enrique Hernandez. Hernandez goes 5 feet, 11 inches, 195 pounds, and he was born in Puerto Rico. And first offering is fouled off. And now the 0-1. There's the strike. Up the middle. And he's safe at first. And here's the catcher, Francisco Alvarez.
Really good piece of hitting last time, going to the opposite field.
First pitch doesn't find the zone. That's inside.
That two-seam fastball is usually coupled with a slider away, and when a hitter's conscious of the pitch in, it's hard for him to cover middle away, and that's where a pitcher can really finish off that batter.
And puts the squeeze on that. One away.
Man, that's one of those at-bats where you have to remind yourself it's about the process. He did everything right there. Nothing to show for it, but in your mind, you have to convince yourself that it was a very good at-bat.
Base hit, center field.
The first
one down. So up next for New York, Yandy Diaz. One for three. Swings and blasts one deep to left center. That one back there. And it's off the wall. One run is in. Cut off, throw to second, but he's in there easily.
Didn't take long to get a result for that at bat. Absolutely blasted that one into the gap, but just didn't have quite enough to clear the wall out there. Maybe a little more elevation under it, and it carries over, but that's a swing you'll be happy with every time.
So man aboard, one down, and it's Tatis at the plate. Swings and misses. Strike one. Diaz leads off second with one gone in the inning. That one misses, and it's 1-1. Tatis waits. Now fly ball to right center. And there are two down. Here's Juan Soto.
Hit an absolute tape measure shot last time up.
And a good fastball to start him off at strike one. Swung on, belted. That one is back. Booyah! Juan Soto the opposite way. His second home run of the game, and they add a pair. It's 10-1. Here's the third baseman, Austin Riley. Plenty of offense in this one, Singy. I guess you'd say kind of what we expected, though.
Well, this was a game, looking at the pitching matchup, where you expected offense to score, and not as lopsided as this. But, yeah, you definitely expected to see some offense coming up.
Here's a rip to short, but he's there for the third out. Top of inning number 7. Now here is Tommy Edman. Denelson Lamet gets the ball now.
Compared to some days, this is a pretty low leverage appearance for him, so he should be fairly free and easy out there. Still have to keep yourself sharp and attack the strike zone.
The pitch. That one ripped. Takes it in for the out.
Nothing you can do about those as a hitter. Even though you know that, they still drive you absolutely crazy.
Jansen. Now at the plate as he swings through strike one. Comes up empty on the swing. 0-2 now.
Two really good back-to-back sliders. Now in an 0-2 count. He's feeling real confident about finishing this hitter off. He can go anywhere he wants.
Cuts on it and misses. That's a strikeout. Slider got him for strike three. Two outs, base is empty. And now the first baseman, Paul Goldschmidt. First pitch swinging.
Just not able to catch up to that velocity.
Swing and a miss. And it's nothing in two. Time asked for at the plate. Maybe an attempt to break up the rhythm that he's got going on the mound right now. Two outs. Got him. And good work there as he gets a 1-2-3. And welcome back. Max Kepler at the plate.
No less than you. Max Kepler, your attention, please. Now, pitching for the Cardinals, number 64, Jake Wall.
The pitch. Swings through that one. Pitch misses, and 1-1. And he flips a breaking ball in there, or a changeup.
Either one, something off speed. Good arm action on it, whatever it was.
Called strike three on the fastball, and that ran back over the inner half. And next for the Mets, Ronnie Mauricio. Liner, base hit. So a man aboard now with one away.
Now batting.
And stepping in for New York, Enrique Hernandez. That one's in there, 0-1. Mauricio leads off first with one away. This to center field. Puts it away for the out. Here's the catcher for the Mets, Francisco Alvarez. That one's in there. That's strike one.
Looks like he sacrificed a pitch right down the middle for tracking and timing. Some good hitters will do that.
Drilled out towards left center field. That's well struck. Booyah! So he leaves the yard to left, and they throw a pair on the board. It's 12-1.